हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम संपदा कुलकर्णी, वेलकम्स यू इन माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स। इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द कंसेप्ट ऑफ बाइनरी सर्च ट्री। टिल नाउ आई हैव एक्सप्लेन द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ अ बाइनरी सर्च ट्री, इट्स रिप्रेजेंटेशन एंड विच ऑपरेशंस दैट कैन बी परफॉर्म ऑन अ बाइनरी सर्च ट्री। फ्रॉम दीज ऑपरेशंस आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन द क्रिएट एंड इंसर्ट ऑपरेशन विथ फर्स्ट सॉल्व एग्जाम्पल, एंड नाउ इन दिस वीडियो I am going to cover the another solved example for your better preparation. In the next video of this video series, I am going to explain you the search operation, the delete operation, and the display operation onto the binary search tree. So, for the understanding of a binary search tree, stay tuned with my channel Tech Talks. For that, subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. So let's see the characteristics of a binary search tree. Binary search tree is a special kind of a binary tree which is having a special behavior. Which is that special behavior? The behavior is every time every left child is having a value which is less than its parent value, and every right child is having a value which is greater than its parent value. For your reference, I am providing you a example of the binary search tree, where if let's consider 27 as a parent node, its left child is having value which is less than 27 and its right child which is having value greater than 27. Let's compare 35 with its left child and a right child, and you can see the left child value is less than parent node, right child value is greater than parent node. You can observe any of the node, say compare 14 with its left child and right child, left child is having less value than that of the parent node, right child is having greater value than that of the parent node. These basic operations that can be performed on a binary search tree. So let's start with the create operation. And here in this video session, I am going to explain you create and insert operation on a binary search tree. So what is create operation? So create operation will help you to create a binary search tree, and that can be performed with the insertion of very first node into the binary search tree. So the first inserted node that we are going to treat as a root node into a binary search tree. Let's perform the next operation, which is insertion operation, which will help you to insert an element into the binary search tree. So while insertion of the node into the binary search tree, we have to locate a proper position for the new key value that we want to insert into the binary search tree. For that, we have to perform comparison operation. So we have to start from a root node, and then we have to perform the comparison operation by comparing your insertion key with the root value. If the key is less than the root value, go to the left subtree and find out a proper position in a left subtree for the insertion of new key value. Otherwise, if key value is greater than the root node, then go to the right subtree and find out a proper position into the right subtree. These steps you have to perform repeatedly to find out the proper position of a new key value into the, or while insertion of a new key value into the binary search tree. So this is the another example that we are going to learn now, and let's see, this is the first node we have created or inserted into the binary search tree for the creation of a binary search tree. And now the next, all the elements that we are going to insert into the binary search tree. So let's compare 86 with a parent node, a root node 56, and as it is greater than 56, let's check for right child. As it is not present, attach it as a right child. Let's accept a new key value which is 65. Let's compare it with a root node first of all. As a 65 key value is greater than a root node, let's check for its right child. As it is present, step down to a right child and make it as a root node, and again compare key value with a current root node. As key value is less than the current root node 86, let's check for its left child. Though no left child is present, attach it as a left child. Let's accept a new value for the insertion operation. it is 79. Let's start with the comparison from the root node. As key value 79 is greater than the root value 56, root value 52, let's check for its right child. As it is present, let's compare the key value with the current root node 86. As 79 is less than 86, let's check for its left child, as we have to find out a proper position into the left subtree. The left child is 65, make it as a root node and compare it with the key value. Key value 79 is greater than a root node. Let's check for the right child of 65. As it is not present, attach it as a right child. Let's accept a new value 24 as an insertion key. Let's start comparison with a root node 52. As 24 is less than 52 and no left child is present to 52, attach it as a left child. Let's accept a new value 18. Again start comparison with the root node. As 18 is less than 52, move to the left child as it is present, make it as a root node and compare a root node with the key value. As key value is less than current root node, let's check for its left child. As it is not present, attach it as a left child. Let's accept a new key value 21. Start comparison with the root node. As 21 is less than 52, move to its left child. As 21 is less than 24, move to its left child. As 21 is greater than 18 and no right child is present, as it is greater, attach it as a right child. Accept a new value from a user. It is 12. Let's compare it with 52. Less than 52, move to right left child, make it as a root node and compare once again. 12, which is less than a current root node, let's check for its right child. It is present and make it as a root node. After making 18 as a root node, let's compare it with the key value. As key value is less than a root node, let's check for its left child. As it is not present, attach 12 as a left child to the current root node 18. Let's accept a new value 7. Let's start for the comparison with 52 as a root node. As a 52 root node, which is less greater than a key value, move to its left child. 7 is less than 24, move to its left child. 18, again comparison with 18, again 7 is less than 18, move to its left child. 12, make it as a root node, compare it with 12. 7 is less than 12, no left child is present, that's why attach it as a left child to the root node 7, to the root node 12. Now let's accept a new key value, compare it with the root node 52, less than 52, compare it 24, less than 24, compare it with 18, less than 18, compare it with 12, greater than 12, and no right child is present, that's why attach it as a right child. 91, compare it with 52, greater than 52, compare with 86, no right child is present to 86, attach it as a right child to the root node 86. Let's accept a new value 94. Let's start with the comparison from a root node, compare with 52, greater than 52, compare with 86, greater than 86, compare with 91, greater than 91, let's attach it as a right child, as no right child is present for the current root node 91. Now let's accept a new value 75. After accepting a new value 75, let's start with the comparison with root node 52. Greater than 52, compare with 86. Less than 86, compare with 65. Greater than 65, compare with 79. And after comparison with 79, less than 79 and no left child is present, attach it as a left child. And let's accept the last value 85. Start comparison with a root node, greater than root node, let's compare with 86, less than 86, let's compare with its left child 65, greater than 85, let's compare it with the right child of 65, 79, greater than 79 and no left child, no right child is present, that's why attach it as a right child. So in this way we can perform the insertion operation of a node onto a binary search tree. So thank you friends for listening and watching this video. If you like the content and the video, please do not forget to give the comment and do not forget to share it with your friends. Here I am providing you a subscription link for my channel Tech Talks. Along with this, I am providing you a shortcut link for this, for the next video of this video series and the whole playlist that I am going to provide you in the form of playlist. Thank you. Happy data structuring. Happy learning. Thank you.